Before we go ahead and move on, of course, as always, just want to take another quick time out and welcome you to the video. Got some lines and personal leans out for SEC football week 8. And, trying something new here, breaking down the videos per conference. So we'll see how it goes. But know a lot of you guys out there love yourself some SEC football. I know I love SEC football, Big Ten. I love all college football. But just got to quickly remind you before we go ahead and move on that we are currently hitting at 65% our last 21 crowd pleaser teasers on patreon.com/BrockPage. And access to that content costs just $9.99. We're also hitting at 63% our last 25 picks in that very same category as well. Once again, we currently have over 795 members signed up and active on that site. And if you want to join them and get in on the action, link for that site is in the description section below. A lot of great stuff going on Patreon. And once again, that is patreon.com/BrockPage. And moving on, we're going to take a look at Kentucky squaring off against Missouri. And that's going to be a 4 p.m. Eastern start time. The Wildcats of Kentucky are the 5-point favorite on the road. Totals 47. Now, Mizzou's plus $1.85 for some money line cash. The Tigers lost 2 out of their first 3 contests of 2020. A 23-point loss to Tennessee and a 19-point loss to the Crimson Tide. Now, they are taking on a Kentucky squad who's coming off a very impressive 34-7 victory over the Tennessee Volunteers. They actually held the Vols scoreless in the entire second half in that matchup there. Really playing some good defense, especially late in that contest. They also beat Mississippi State by the final of 24-2. Kind of a weird score there, 24-2 the week before that. This Wildcat secondary has 9 interceptions on the season, 2 by Kelvin Joseph out of the secondary, and 2 by linebacker Jamin Davis, who also has 35 tackles and a sack. And along with going 2-0 against the spread in their last couple of ball games, this Wildcat offense is averaging 33 points a game in their last 3 outings as well. Chris Rodriguez has carried it 46 times for 257 yards and 4 scores. And quarterback Terry Wilson is also averaging 4.5 yards a carry, and he's scored 3 times on the ground himself. And if Wilson does want to air it out, his favorite target, his favorite receiver has been Josh Ali, who has 22 catches for 246 yards. Now, total-wise, 3 out of Kentucky's last 4 games stayed under the total of 47 points. The Wildcats are also 2-0 to the under when they travel. And they've gone 9-2 to the under in their last 11 conference ball games, if you're into historical trends there. Meanwhile, the Tigers of Mizzou on the other side, they went 9-3 to the under in their last dozen as home. Of course, that dates back to last season. Now, 5 out of their last 6 head-to-head meetings with Kentucky also stayed under the line. Give me the Kentucky Wildcats -5 and the under 47 in that contest. And with that, we're going to dive into our next and final matchup for the show. Only a handful of SEC games this week, but anyway, we're going to take a look at South Carolina squaring off against LSU. And that's going to be a 7 p.m. Eastern start time in the Bayou. The Tigers of Louisiana State are the 5.5-point favorite at home. Totals 55 flat. Now, the Gamecocks are plus $1.85 for some money line cash. They're also currently on a